Coronavirus crisis has reached a dangerous new peak. Victoria's cases surging to 784 today, marking Australia's single worst day for new infections since the beginning of the pandemic. Of those new cases, only 97 have known sources, and there have been more than two deaths, bringing the national total to 128. Alarming new data has revealed 9 out of 10 Victorians went to work when they started feeling sick, and almost half of those infected patients did not isolate while they were waiting for test results.
They have gone out shopping, they have gone to work, they have been at the height of their infectivity, and they have just continued on as usual.
That means that we're going to look at 500, 600 cases per day. I absolutely don't want us to go there.
We have been warned now the six-week lockdown of Melbourne could be extended. And this all comes as authorities here in New South Wales work to strengthen our border with Victoria. Damien Ryan joins us this afternoon. Damo, good afternoon. We've seen a big movement from police to Albury today.
Well, such a grim prediction of what we've seen and, you know, in Victoria, and it's come true, you know, over 400 cases. We have to stop it at the door, and that's what we saw today. More police leaving Sydney, bound for the Victorian border. A new system of permit system has kicked in down there, and it's going to make it harder for, obviously, vehicles and people to cross the border. Even if you live in Albury and Wodonga, it's now going to be very strict. And there's a good reason for that, because we know that the leakage of the virus out of Victoria has caused a lot of damage here in New South Wales. We now know that the cluster, the three main clusters, which have caused all these problems in New South Wales, the Crossroads cluster, the Thai restaurant one, and the Batemans Bay, have all been linked to a strain of the virus which has come from Victoria. So that confirmation today really backs up why these police are so important to make that line, the blue line, thicker in Victoria, to make sure that we don't have any more hiccups like we've just had. As I said, three cases, all connected to Victoria. That confirmation today was delivered by our Chief Health Officer Kerry Chant.
The sequencing of the virus has helped us understand that they're all a strain similar to that circulating in Victoria. Now, that's important to note that we don't think they're all from the one person. What they represent is that the virus is similar, and we believe that there were different sources of exposure.
OK, so in terms of Sydney then, the Thai Rock restaurant cluster, that's spreading.
That's spreading, but it's basically under control at this point. We know that there were 16 new cases in New South Wales in the last 24 hours. Three of those were connected to the Crossroads Hotel, 11 with the Thai Rock restaurant, and the others are all known sources. And that is the really strong point here, that they know where the virus, this source has come from, who's responsible, and they can lock it in and contain it. So it's been, from what's gone on in Victoria, it's been a pretty good 24 hours. There's a sigh of relief, no doubt, that they managed to track down everything that's occurred in the last 48 hours in terms of these cases. So fingers crossed, it's been a good day for us, but we know what can happen. Just look at Victoria.
It's been a horrible day for them. Okay, Damo, thank you. Well, meanwhile, the government is counting the economic cost of the pandemic. We'll go live to Jonathan Kersley, who's in Canberra. Jonathan, good afternoon. What does this mean for tomorrow's update from the Treasurer?
Well, Davina, effectively, the government is working off a best-case scenario, and that's because this virus is so unpredictable and can change things so quickly. All you have to do is look at Victoria as evidence of that. The Treasurer, Josh Frydenberg, has travelled from the virus-hit state to be in Canberra to deliver tomorrow's economic update, complete with his own sign of the times, a directive from the ACT Health Minister that mask must be worn at all times. And the Treasurer is warning of eye-watering numbers, and that is because by the end of May, revenue had slumped and expenses had soared by more than $50 billion. That means, Davina, a deficit could be somewhere close to $100 billion and $200 billion in this financial year. That is well above what we saw at the height of the global financial crisis.
You're going to see eye-watering numbers around debt and deficit, numbers that Australians have never, ever seen before. That's the harsh reality of this pandemic.
We need to know how bad the government expects this recession to get, how high unemployment will be for how long, and how much extra debt has piled up.
And what makes the best guess scenario worse, Davina, is the unpredictability, because a greater lockdown, if that does happen in Victoria, would mean increased losses to revenue. It would also cripple personal spending. And remember too that right now we are in the height of a recession. So shutting down businesses, crippling personal spending for longer, well, that could make it a whole lot worse.
Yeah, it's a worry. Okay, Jono, thank you. Ukrainian police have arrested an armed man and released up to 20 hostages after a nine-hour-long standoff. The hostages are believed to be unharmed, but police say at one point officers did come under fire. The suspect has been named as a Russian national who is known to police for previous weapons offences. Coronavirus has swept through a convent in North America, killing 12 nuns in the space of a month. The women were aged between 69 and 99, all long-term members of a convent in Michigan. A 13th sister initially survived the virus but passed away in June. Authorities are having a hard time tracking down this whale who was seen swimming off Cronulla with what appears to be a rope tied to its fin. A fishing boat and maritime services were out searching, but it seems the whale is too quick for them. We have some special footage to show you right now of what is hopefully a moment in history. People lining the streets near Mascot to farewell the last Qantas Boeing 747 jumbo jet as it takes to Australia's skies for the final time. It brings an end to five decades of history-making moments for the service.
Qantas 7474, for the last time, you're clear for takeoff.
And for the last time, again, 16 right, clear for takeoff, Qantas 7474.
And Sydney has turned on a sparkler to farewell the 747. It's on its way down to Wollongong at the moment, and then we'll fly back towards Sydney and we'll keep an eye on the sky for the Queen of the Sky and salute her final journey.